2019 began in Jakarta, Indonesia, with one eternal glory. Thailand's Mongkol Pet Pet Indie Academy is undeniably one of the finest Muay Thai artists in the world and stands as a Lumpini Stadium Muay Thai World Champion. Stepping into the ONE Championship circle for the first time, he faced off against New Zealand's two-time Muay Thai World Champion, Alexi Serapisos.
Nice counter there from Serapisos, and Mongkol Pet upends him, advances towards his corner. Couple of fakes and feints, thrusts the jab, does the New Zealander. Serapisos not committing on the hand, needs to. Nice jab there from Serapisos. Mongkol Pet didn't like it, so he rushes forward, tries to lock on the clinch, tries for a crossing elbow, and a knee looks to fold Serapisos in half. And he comes forward again, the Thai, the Lumpini World Champion. He tries for the jab. Good roundhouse kick off the lead leg from the Thai. Oh, big cheap kick. How taste my feet, says Mongkol Pet. And again from the Thai. What a performance from Alexi Serapisos. And what a performance from Mongkol Pet Pet Indie Academy.
All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. Mongkol Pet Pet Indie Academy.
A highly anticipated rematch was next on the card. The now ONE Lightweight World Champion and ONE Lightweight World Grand Prix Champion, Christian Lee, had a life-changing year. But 2019 began before Lee earned his world titles and was competing in the featherweight division. His first opponent of the year was Team Lakai's Edward Kelly. These men already had a history. In 2018, their first competition ended in controversy, with Kelly taking the win by disqualification due to an illegal suplex from Lee. This rematch gave both men the opportunity to prove themselves and continue their rise in the featherweight division.
The high kick from Lee. They clinch up for the first time.
Christian Lee's got a nasty front headlock, snatches Kelly down. Oh, he snatches up, but look at that choke right there. Look at those long arms. Kelly would rather stay in the mount and get smashed on than give up his back.
Ground and pound again, and it's good night, Irene! He did as he promised. He did as he predicted. Christian Lee makes short work of ferocious Edward Kelly.
The year began victoriously for Lee and continued to world championship gold. Russia's Rasul Yakiyaev faced off against Japan's Koji Ando. Yakiyaev was hesitant in the face of Ando's jab, which he pumped from the southpaw stance to keep his opponent at bay and deal damage without committing to any risky offense. The pace picked up in the second half of the first round as the right hand started to land for the Russian, but his opponent responded by staying in boxing range and pushing forward with more straight punches. In the second round, Ando took the center of the stage and continued to dictate the striking exchanges. Ando barely took a backward step as he connected with stiff, straight punches. Yakiyaev connected with his best punch of the bout towards the end of the stanza when he launched a straight right hand at Ando, which initiated a furious exchange. However, Ando got some shots in too and then re-established his boxing dominance before the bell rang. The dynamic of the lightweight contest briefly changed in the third frame. Yakiyaev was able to get a body lock on Ando and then wrestled him down to the mat, but the Japanese star did not take long to get back to his feet. As soon as the encounter was upright, he was soon firing off punches. After 15 minutes of action, the outcome was left in the official's hands. Ando earned the victory via split decision. Homegrown hero Priscilla Hurtado Lumbongao, a Wushu World Champion medalist, entered 2019 off the back of five incredible wins in 2018. Motivated and determined to keep the momentum going, she faced India's Pooja Tomar. Tomar, a multiple-time Indian national Wushu champion, hadn't had the same success in ONE Championship as her opponent, with losses to Tiffany Teo and Jihin Radzwan. Tomar entered the circle to make a statement that she belongs on the global stage, competing against the best in the world.
If Priscilla gets the win, particularly by knockout or submission, they will have an absolute meltdown inside this sold-out arena.
Very comfortable stance, and that southpaw position. She utilized that push kick very well.
Here's Pujatoma. There's a side kick from the Indian. There is quite a bit of swelling above the right eye of Priscilla Hertati Lumbango. Take down there, and Toma finds herself in top position. Look at the pass to the guard of the Indonesian. Priscilla has 2 out of 5 wins by submission. Ground and pound attempt, looks to pass to side control now Toma, and gets there the Indian. Have a look at this from Pujatoma. She's gonna try and mount Priscilla Hernandez Lumbango. She takes the back. It's crazy here from Toma. She's got her back, oh my! Oh my! She's got the hooks in. And can she flatten her out? Yes, she can!
Wow, that's a shocker. Look at Tomar getting control of the back now.
My word, Pujatoma in control. Nobody expected this. Nobody expected this. Incredible scene here in Jakarta.
Just as I say that, she gets dumped on her butt.
She's going to hunt after a submission. They're both playing a submission game, Dragon.
Not much there. Possible knee bar. Oh, wait, is she going to go out of it? That was close.
Oh, Tomar looks like she's in pain. Tomar's grimacing.
Oh, didn't quite have it.
Just missed with a counter. Here it goes. Boom! Shakalaka! Unrelenting with the left hand. And Toma tries to defend against those punches. Final 10 seconds. Can she choke her? It's more of a face crank. What a match. This was one for the ages.
By split decision, who
former ONE Flyweight Muay Thai World Champion, Jonathan Haggerty, began the year with his ONE Championship debut. 2019 proved to be a dramatic year for the Englishman, and it all began with his Muay Thai bout against the always game Italian, Joseph Lasiri. Lasiri, a WBA Super Bantamweight Muay Thai World Champion, is a fan favorite in ONE Championship for his tenacious heart and never quit attitude.
This could get nasty. A beautiful teeth to open up there from Haggerty. And another teeth to the midsection of the Italian. Great showdown tonight to see who really is the better in this weight class. And there's the first one off the right arm. A crossing elbow from Haggerty. Front kick, I'll taste my feet. Big elbow again. Oh, Lasiri just stumbles there. That elbow didn't connect, but already two have connected for Haggerty. Oh, Haggerty changes angle, slams the shin into the ribs again. Cracking roundhouse kick to the ribs, a front kick go to the jaw. Downward elbow. Lasiri throws a knee of his own to the left ribs. Planting elbow from the Italian, backs up Haggerty now. That's more like it from Lasiri. Downward elbow, downward elbow, downward elbow. He cracked him a beauty! He cracked him a beauty! Downward elbow! Lasiri on rubber legs! He's stumbling! Jumping knee! And Lasiri almost tucked the knee under the jaw. Crossing elbow. Oh, beautiful clinch and just dumped him to the canvas. This is a brilliant Muay Thai matchup in ONE Super Series. And he capitalized. Lasiri now the hands! He ties him up! A chance for the knee! Inside leg kick, Lasiri spinning back fist from the Italian. And beautiful done there. Lasiri, Highland roundhouse kick, and he's cut Lasiri. Lasiri's cut just over the left eye. This has been a back and forth battle. Thought about the front kick to Lasiri. Haggerty with the elbow, the left roundhouse kick. Elbow on the inside. They clinch up now.
Your winner by unanimous decision, Jonathan Haggerty.
Haggerty's winning ways didn't end there, and he shocked the world to earn ONE World Championship gold later in the year. Anthony Anglin was on a resurgence, having claimed back-to-back victories within the space of just 8 days following his return to ONE Championship in November 2018. The Jakarta-based Dutchman intended to build on his momentum against Kwan Wan Il.
Anglin, the Archangel, and the pretty boy, Kwan Wan Il. Outside low kick from Anglin. And again from England. But wait until Kwan Wan Il lands the straight right hand. That's his bread and butter combination. I should say, being Korean, that's his kimchi combination.
I like that right hand though. It's slipping right through. It hasn't quite found a home yet, but he's moving quite well. Kwan Wan Il is a Taekwondo black belt, so he's got a lot of sneaky kicks, but he hides it high behind all that right hand.
He says he uses the Taekwondo footwork to enable him to use his hands, which is very interesting. I haven't heard that before, using Taekwondo footwork, which is usually reserved for kicking in Taekwondo, being a kicking martial art, but he uses it to slap his hands, and so far, he has knocked out a lot of opponents with that straight right.
Nice takedown defense from Kwon Wan Il. I was questioning his takedown defense. He's primarily a stand-up.
Oh, there it is, the big kibosh. It's good night, Irene. That's what he said he'd do. The straight right hand, we called it again. The prophecy of Kwon Wan Il rings true on his one championship debut. Straight right hand, smack bang on the bearded jaw of Anthony England, and the angel has fallen.
Wow, that was a beautifully timed right hand, Michael. His footwork was coming clean. I like the way he was timing it. It slipped through the guard, it found a home, and connected perfectly on the chin of England. Let's take a look at that again, because that was pretty. Watch this, chin tucked nice and tight. All you newcomers out there, check out that chin. Bingo, right there on the button. Swarms on him, jumps all over, starts landing some shots. Kim Chang jumps in to stop it. Look at that, connected again on the way down. A little bit of a protest there from Anthony England there, but I think Kim Chang saw something that he didn't, because he was out. He saved him from a lot of unnecessary damage, Michael.
I'll call it now, Mitch. Kwon Wan Il is the new featherweight to watch in 2019.
For your winner, by way of technical knockout, Kwon Wan Il!
A spectacular display of martial arts skill from Kwon. IFMA Muay Thai World Champion and Philippines National Wushu Sanda Champion, Robin Catalan, competed against the best athletes in the strawweight division. But following a loss against Japanese veteran Hayato Suzuki, the pressure was on Catalan to make a strong comeback in the circle. His opponent, Indonesian superstar Stefer Rahardian, also had pressure on his shoulders in the same situation as Catalan. Rahardian aimed to come back from a losing streak.
The intensity in his eyes, the hook to the right hand, the outside thigh kick combination. The uppercut misses the target. Rahardian tries to counter. A hook off the backhand, off the leg kick from Catalan. For Rahardian's last win, you've got to go back to May of last year. His victory over Himanshu Kaushik in the first round by Rio Naked Choke. Listen to those excited screams from this sold-out audience here in Jakarta. It sounds like a football crowd. Oh, the big right hand smack bang on the chin from Catalan. There it is now from Catalan. Good outside leg kick just to that common peroneal nerve above the left knee from Stefer Rahardian.
Rahardian's got to tuck that chin. Beautiful takedown from Catalan. Timed it wonderfully. Landed the right hand and then goes right underneath it and secures a double leg.
Hey, Rahardian trying to cut off the movement. Boom, shakalaka. Big takedown there from Catalan.
Beautiful. Came underneath the punches.
And there's the end of the match. We've gone the distance and Catalan pumps his fists in the air. And look at the sportsmanship.
By unanimous decision, Robin Catalan!
Two-time Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu no-gi world champion, Bruno Pucci, faced off against former ONE lightweight world champion, Kotetsu Boku. Boku looked relaxed on his feet when the featherweight contest began, but he was soon forced to take evasive action when his opponent charged forward to tie him up against the fence within the first 20 seconds. Though he was caught in a tight body lock, the Japanese veteran showed incredible balance to stay upright as he attempted to avoid the ground at all costs. He tried to take Pucci's focus away from the takedown with short punches, but the Evolve representative eventually forced his adversary to crash onto the canvas. As soon as Pucci had the match where he wanted it, he put his rival in danger. He immediately flattened Boku out in half guard, and despite the attempts to halt the Brazilian passing guard, he soon moved into side control. Things quickly got worse for the 41-year-old from Tokyo as Pucci transitioned to his back and quickly locked up a rear naked choke. His palm-to-palm grip was tight, and it only took a moment for Boku to tap out and concede defeat, earning Pucci the biggest win of his mixed martial arts career. New Can Can made his ONE championship debut, and it was one to remember. faced off against local hero Sunoto, it's a blink and you'll miss it affair.
Sunoto controlling center cage. Oh, the good night, Irene! One kick, that's all it took! New Kung Kung is for real!
Wow, that was beautiful! I liked his lateral movement. He was moving left, he was moving right, really calm, really relaxed. That was a beautifully timed and placed high kick.
Indonesian karate champion Aziz Kalem took on national Sanda champion Adi Perianto in an all-Indonesian strawweight bout. The match started off with Perianto looking to establish his striking by connecting with a succession of powerful leg kicks. However, Kalem exhibited ice-cool composure as he calmly walked down his opponent, cut off the cage, and closed the distance. He unloaded a slew of powerful punches, one of which turned the bout in his favor almost instantly. A solid right hand dropped Perianto, but he immediately bounced back to his feet and wheeled away from trouble. Kalem established himself as the aggressor, and he took charge of the bout from that moment on. Kalem changed levels to score a decisive takedown, but he opted to let his man get back up as he looked to continue his striking success. It seemed as though Perianto wanted to take the action back to the canvas, however. Perianto initially landed a double leg takedown, but when his adversary returned to his feet, he attempted a body lock takedown. The maneuver went awry, however, as Kalem landed on top in the full mount position and kept his rival on the mat for the remainder of the contest. Kalem landed powerful ground strikes and remained active on the ground as he punished Perianto for his errant takedown attempt. After flattening out his opponent and softening him up with the powerful ground and pound, Kalem switched to a rear naked choke. He forced the quick tap from his fellow countryman with just 20 seconds left in the first round. Oscar Yakut started off his featherweight match like a house on fire as he launched looping punches at his opponent, Salatiga's Andreas Satawan. The national Sanda gold medalist appeared to hurt Satawan in the opening exchanges, and then again with a big overhand right just a minute into the match, but he held on and quickly recovered. Moments later, the momentum shifted as Satawan grabbed a standing arm-in guillotine choke against the fence. But he could not capitalize, however, and Yakut soon found himself free. Yakut continued to march forward. He threw everything into his offense just like he had done at the start of the round. But the volume of strikes began to decrease as the opening stanza drew to a close. At the beginning of the second period, Satawan seemed determined. He walked through his rival's best shots and showed his strength in the clinch. Satawan went for a guillotine choke again, and he looked to have it locked up as he closed guard when the contest went to the canvas. But his fortunes changed rapidly from that very moment. Yakut popped his head out to escape the submission and passed guard into mount almost immediately, where he unloaded heavy punches and elbows until Satawan tapped out.
Oh, he tapped!
Wow, did he tap out for the ground and pound, Mitch?
He tapped out from the ground and pound. He did not like being in that mounted position.
Oscar Yakut!
The main event featured the fan favorite and always exciting one strawweight world champion, Joshua Pascio. Pascio's rise to the top of the martial arts world is outstanding. His high-level skill set and athleticism is a testament to his rigorous training at the famed Team Lakai in Baguio City, Philippines. Pascio stepped into the circle against an extremely powerful opponent, Japanese contender Yosuke Tsuruta. Tsuruta, a former gymnast and shoot strawweight world champion, made a mark in the Japanese martial arts scene. Tsuruta's debut in ONE Championship pitted him against former ONE strawweight world champion Alex Silva. Tsuruta defeated the Brazilian with a stunning performance to earn his shot at Pascio's belt.
Oh, head kick came close there from Pascio, and we're on the ground for the first time. Pascio looking for a way back to his feet. Is he going to get there? A jumping roundhouse kick. Nice skip up on it there from Joshua Pascio. Tsuruta would love to put Pascio on his back again. Work some ground and pound. Try to find a submission. Nice little digging uppercut there from Pascio. Tsuruta shoots in for the takedown. They're on the canvas now with 45 seconds left in this round. Some acrobatics there. Tsuruta back to his feet. Big right hand from Tsuruta. He loaded up with that one. Missed the target, though. Trying to get off first with his punches. The Japanese challenger gets out of the way of the high kick. Jabs his way in, but shoots him for a double leg. Stops the takedown attempt. Does Paschio. Nicely done from the champion. Oh, guillotine attempt from Paschio. See if Tsuruta doesn't bring that arm back or drop it completely, leaving him exposed on that left side. John jump turning back kick. Paschio implodes. Oh, jumping roundhouse kick. He stunned him. And there's the right hand from Paschio. And now the power salvos from the strawweight world champion. A charging single leg takedown off the bell. And Tsuruta top position. Oh, Paschio gets back to his feet. What a start to this penultimate round. The aggressive meter suddenly rises.
Good takedown defense, but Tsuruta is able to clasp his hands. Gently sets him down.
Final seconds of the fourth round. We're going to go into the deepest of deep water, the fifth and final in this world title main event. Champion versus champion. Striking versus grappling. Paschio and Tsuruta. And they open up with the acrobatics, with the heavy artillery. Tsuruta high on the balls of his feet. The head movement here. Oh, spinning back elbow from Paschio.
That was a different type of takedown. Paschio had his number on this, but watch Paschio trying to scramble back up. Oh, but he's in full mount now. But look at him scramble back up to his feet, Joshua Paschio.
Tsuruta goes high, then grabs a hold of the legs, trying to plant Paschio, and he gets him down. Final 10 seconds, a chance for a late flurry of ground and pound from the Japanese. Goes for the right hand. Paschio raises the legs. A wild flurry on the ground. And that's the end of the fifth and final round.
Wow, that was so close.
For your winner, by split decision, and new one strawweight world champion, Yosuke Tsuruta!
Tsuruta and Paschio faced off once again later in the year at One Roots of Honor.
This is Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.